Bit of a timer on the attacking team where it puts all the more pressure for that first attack to be successful. Because if you lose that first attack and you end up giving up a shield generator, your job becomes far, far harder. So if Fnatic is going to be going up against that defensive Symmetra, they really have to hope that they get a strong early attack to start things out.
And of course, it does look like they're going some of the forward defenses with Symmetra. You always want to put those out a little bit further ahead so you can start building that ultimate charge with Symmetra as fast as possible. It doesn't really matter if they get destroyed. Even if they just tick someone for about 10 damage, that's all they're looking for there. And it does look like Fnatic's going to go with a pretty standard quad tank composition here. Cool Matt on the Zarya. Got Buds walking in on the Roadhog, looking for the first couple of picks in this fight.
This is pure power coming out here from Fnatic, where they're going to be looking to break that shield early on. They are taking the brute force approach. Buds looking for the hook over the top, not going to get it early on, but who is going to get that hook? It's going to be Taimu putting Fnatic in a rough position as Picky just comes in, picks up two towards the end, and this fight going the way of Envy.
That fight ended before it started. I don't know where all those kills came from. There was barely a skirmish there, and then just several people died. They're gonna have to repush this in just another second.
All right, and now here's the key part, is that Internet Hulk does put down that shield generator. Suddenly for Fnatic, they're going to this next fight, and their job is far, far harder than it was in the first push. Now they really have to hope for Buds to go in and get that early hook. And look at that. That's so well protected in the back. It's going to be difficult for Fnatic to deal with it. But next fight underway, Fnatic diving right in, just looking for the early pick, and they're not getting it just yet.
Yeah, Harry Hook is doing a good job fighting D.Va over here, trying to find some damage. Stupa's actually really low, being a little bit brazen there, taking a shield down for a second, charging in.
Charging in, and Stoop gets on the chips, but it's Envy fighting it right back. Harry Hook operates Attack Visor, picks up a quick two, and it's a little bit bloody here for Envy. Bloodier than they would really like under the circumstances, but they do just enough to hold on to the point and push back Fnatic.
Oh, and there's another hook coming out from Taimu. He's been grabbing a couple of good ones. He's been starting off these fights definitely in a favorable position for Envious here, and the shield generator has been so far in the back and so well defended, hasn't even come into play yet. There hasn't been a real fight, and so much time has gone down. You see them going around the back now, looking for that big Graviton Surge.
Graviton Surge coming in here for Blacka, pull in two right away. Is Ball 3 gonna be there? Buds takes down Taimu early on, but there's Mickey, the counter self-destruct coming in, pushes Fnatic back, and gives new life here to Envy as they push this back, and they are going to end up holding. And by the way, that shield generator is still up.
The shield generator hasn't been observed. It hasn't been looked at. Like I'm saying, they were barely able even to get on the point before they were just shut down by that Graviton Surge and pushed back. It's so well defended back there, and they're going to have to win a fight while the other enemy team has 75 extra health per person. It's absurd.
Well, here's the big problem for Fnatic is that now they're starting to run out of time. They only have a minute 30 left. They have a Soundbearer up. This next fight is going to be probably their best window in terms of ult advantage.
They don't know where it is.
Yeah.
Even back there looking for the shield generator, they don't actually know where it is yet.
It is a sneaky shield generator. Oh my goodness, Stoop getting picked off. This is going to delay Fnatic's push even more. Maybe they would have had two pushes left, Stir. Now they have just one.
This D.Va in the back line, I'm sorry. Comedy gold. Like, we're losing to this and I want to help. It's impossible. So Hafakul is going to go down with nothing done. There's only a minute left. They only have one push for this to work. They have the ultimates, they have a chance here, but the shield generator, which is shrouded in shadows, may be their downfall.
It's a myth, it's a legend. Fnatic has not been able to find their own personal version of the Holy Grail, but they are gonna try and brute force this. They're coming in up the front. Bonathil gonna be looking to drop the beat. You have Hafakul going into the cafe, and he's gonna stop Harry Hook from doing exactly what he wants here. Defensive Matrix right in his face. That's really good to protect Fnatic, but Fnatic has not gotten a single killer to start things off. Instead, Mickey blows up the back line, sets up Taimu. Three kills here from Envious, as only 28 seconds remain.
I don't know really what's going wrong for Fnatic here. They just get wiped once again. They can barely get into this fight. They're not getting a single kill in these fights. They have 20 seconds, maybe just enough to walk forward and see their precious goal, the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow there.
Is it a moral victory if they just get the shield generator even while losing at this point?
No, that's just... That's when you realize where it was the whole time and just hit yourself in the head.
That is fair, but here we go. The true last fight on the way here. Fnatic rolling in, trying to get anything going. No, they don't touch the point. They can't get on there in time. There is no overtime, but there is a full hold here from Envious, and that is a statement to start out this series.
Jeez, yeah, that's what we're talking about. Before we mention that this first match would set the pace for everything else to see how this was actually going to play out, see how strong Envious really was, and they looked uncontested. They looked like Fnatic can't do a single thing to not one of their players.
And this is really just demoralizing for Fnatic because now their best case scenario right now is to hold for 4 minutes and only get a draw. Usually when you get the first point hold, you can look forward to, oh, we're gonna win. Now they have to do that just to break even. It's never a good position to be in as a team.
Yeah, I mean, if you really are going for a full hold on first point, too, you have a lot of things you're going to want to consider. It doesn't seem like they're going with anything extraordinary. They don't want to do the Symmetra themselves, no Torbjorn.
I think they actually do want to go the Symmetra here, even though they're not, because Symmetra is sort of a gamble, right, in that your first defense, your very first defense is going to be a little bit weaker because you do not have access to her ultimate or any of the other goodies that she has. But if you can live for a long enough time to get that shield generator up, then your subsequent defenses are much stronger. And unfortunately for Fnatic, they're in the position where they have to gamble to get the long-term defense. Sure, they might defend the first defense here, but over time, Envy should be able to overwhelm them if they play how they usually play.
Especially pushing into a point where you know you only have to capture the first one, you can do so many different things. You can just wait until you have a Zarya ult combo, which it doesn't look like they're going for, but you can just... you know you don't have that much work to put in.
No, absolutely. And Fothill having a little bit of fun by the door, going to be skating back. The fact that Fnatic is running Lucio, not really a surprise worth hiding. But here we go. 8 seconds till the gates open. Envy is going to have a whole lot of time to take this point. And you know what, Stir? There's no pressure on them here either, because even if they fail, they still get to go to a tiebreaker.
Yeah, clean slate. Just, you know, let everything even out. But we're going to have Mickey walking forward first on the D.Va, trying to eat some of that. Hook comes out, doesn't really get anybody. They're going to need that early pick to get something. Hook's going back and forth, just trying to make sure they can do this shield war right now. The shield war, the hooks, the D.Va.
That is our meta right now. Reinhardt shield versus Reinhardt shield, and Envy actually winning this power fight a little bit more. You look at Fnatic's health right now, they are getting poked, they are getting pushed back, as Envy is slowly gaining a bit of ground right now. Now Fnatic, they do heal up, they're coming right back. It is really gonna be determined by who gets that first major hook. Not gonna be Taimu there, but Harry Hook comes in over the top, laying the damage to soldiers, so it's a big poke war here between both teams, but Coolmat takes down Coco, and that might be what Fnatic needs here to get this rolling in their favor.
Yeah, not exactly sure where it's coming from, but Coco was taking a lot more damage to his shield. It kind of broke quite a bit earlier. Still some fighting going on up top. Was there an ultimate used, or am I crazy? I thought I heard someone screaming something in a foreign language. You never know what that might mean.
I just think people have a lot of fun here at Vegas here, Stir. I wouldn't overthink it, but looking here at the defense here for Fnatic. They're in a pretty good spot here. They do have a nano boost. They should be able to use to start things out, and they might just go on Snoop. Snoop was looking like he wanted to dive in, said, pulled back last second and said, eh, maybe not.
Yeah, they're really just building ultimates and not really committing to a single push here. Mickey finally getting the nano boost, able to get in here, try and do some damage, but he doesn't really have a target to fight. D.Va over there isn't worth shooting at. Stoop got an auto boost as well, which isn't really helping anyone.
And you see that for D.Va, Mickey has to go in through the room, packing out, cannot withstand against Stoop's hammer, swings it around, takes down Mickey. And Fnatic's playing this really smart right now. Look at the ultimates as well. They're really holding on to it unless they really need to use it. And going to the next fight, Envy now with only 2 minutes left. They're going to be able to burn 4 ultimates, but they're right running into Fnatic. This entire point might be decided by this ultimate showdown. Here we go. The Groudon Surge is out. Matt going in, picks up 3, but the Sound Barrier going to be protecting it. And oh my goodness, Mickey pierces through, and so does half the Cool. This is pandemonium.
It's D.Va on D.Va action. The nuclear bombs are going off, but it's Envious who's on the point right now. Coco throwing some gigantic fire strikes, trying to get the kill on Coolmat here, but all there is a Lucio to fight it. I don't know if they'll be able to capture the point off of this. They even get a nano boost out there onto the Zarya, and they're going to be able to clean this up and defend the point once more.
They're coming back. The D.Va war is over, but Fnatic going to keep it pushing forward. Coolmat at 75% charge, just melting down D.Va mechs like it is his job. I guess it is his job. And what do you think about Fnatic pushing this far out?
Always risky. You never really want to go too far. They definitely had a couple of picks and they had a chance to, but no matter what, you're going to stagger them the same amount of time either way. Clearly now they're coming back to the point. They don't have the positions they really wanted. Stoop doesn't even have the health he really wanted, the shield health either. He has to back into the cafe, but a Graviton Surge comes down. A couple kills going the way of Fnatic.
And Fnatic, they're able to clean that up, and now here we go, Stir. A minute left for Envy. And Envy now back against the wall. We could be looking at the potential double hold. And what do we expect from Envy in this last push as they've switched up their heroes?
I don't know. They don't really have too many ultimates on their side. I suppose they have more than Fnatic at this point, but the fighting is going on outside of the point. Now, once again, we have Harry Hook on Reaper, not too often seen, getting a lot of damage out of the side of that Roadhog.
That early hook on the stoop was devastating. Now it's a 65 in favor of Envy, and there's the nano boost, but there's the sleep! Kusta with the beautiful sleep, but won't be enough. Fnatic still fighting without two of their big guns. They're down Matt, they're down Stoop, and Harry Hook is in this cafe looking for blood, tearing into this Roadhog. Not gonna get just yet, but a lot of stuff going the way of Envious right now. They still have a full six. They're still fighting. The Sound Bear has come down, and they are giving Fnatic everything they can handle more of it. Yet, Fnatic is fighting back. Here comes the Whole Hog.
Every single time this Reaper tries to do something, he is pushed back, he is put to sleep. They absolutely had this on Envy.
Oh,
he gets blown up by a D.Va mech ult there. Right, it's insane how much they denied Reaper.
And we're in overtime right now. Fnatic fighting for their lives, and they very well could be forcing overtime in a round where we thought it would just be Envy's to take. Envy on the back foot, looking for the miracle, but here comes Taimu, a Whole Hog of his own, gonna be pushing people back. It is at two-thirds right now. Envy's still very capable of taking this point. As he looks for the Allport hook, grabs Buds. Buds, though, going to get away from that. And down goes Taimu as both teams still fighting it out.
This is still carnage. We have Harry Hook out here on the Tracer, trying to take on as many people as he can. Enough damage into that D.Va. The D.Va could go down, but no!
Fnatic striking back. One good first hold deserves another. And in the end, this actually shouldn't be that surprising because we saw a lot of the shenanigans going down at DreamHack where Fnatic, you know, they've kind of made a name for themselves off good defense.
Breaking the mold here because their team picks, their character picks always play with that as well.
So the cool thing here about what Envy is running is that it's multi-threat. Not only is Mickey going to be looking to get to the back line and really drawing some attention, and up as I say that, he's going to D.Va. So going more on his bread and butter.
Mickey disappoints everyone again. He does it with a smile, but he just keeps
I mean, he's probably smiling because he just fooled us if he can hear us in any form or fashion. But either way, the cool thing here for Envy is that they're going to be trying to play a little bit more of a range game. They don't want to brawl Fnatic up in their face. They want to give room for Harry Hook to work right now, as both teams right now take this first fight.
And Harry Hook able to find a couple of shots here onto the back of the tanks. It looks like they've gotten really close up into their face. No team either way really getting a significant advantage over the other two picks. Coco getting one, and it looks like Envious is actually taking control of this fight.
Envy doing very well in this fight to start things out. And I know that first pickoff might have been a boot on the stoop, and it set the stage. Fnatic trying to fight it back a little bit, but I think they're just going to back off, reset, and go again. And the key is here, if they're able to come back quick enough, it will be relatively even ult-wise.
Yeah, they did have to get into their face too because they are running tanks. They have to get up in their face. They're just gonna stand back with Harry Hook putting out the consistent damage, but they wore down the shields fast enough that they outlasted them. They took the shield down, they were able to kill people and some boops into the holes. Of course, we've got Internet Hulk DPS Lucio in the back.
Why not? Internet Hulk is swapping Lucio, pretty multi-talented himself, but here we go, fight is underway, and did that boop happen? It did, Stoop into the pit he goes. And that is a big early pickoff. Envy is going to drop the beat. They want to secure this fight right here, right now. And Fnatic, not with a whole lot of options to actually deal with it.
From 500 health to zero in 1 second. That's a DPS if I've ever seen one.
This is Overwatch, Stern. This is Overwatch. But Envy is coming out strong here, just cleaning things up, not really giving Fnatic much of a prayer. And now the next fight here, Fnatic has got to be thinking they want to use ultimates in this, but Envy has their own war chest as well. So this is probably going to decide the round here if both teams go all in with their ult reserves. And Law's gonna come down here to half a cool and how he can engage this with his D.Va self-destruct.
Yeah, Envy can treat this as a defense though, and we can just talk about how great both of their defenses were. They have Harry Hook coming out here with the nano boosted aim hack, taking out some hits on everybody. They did drop the Lucio boost, but he's finding one kill from an astronaut up high. Stoop about to go down, but not finding any of the last hits that he needs.
All right, it's still even 5v5 between both teams. And Cool Matt, his Graviton just came online a little bit late in the fight. Look at Mickey tearing down Stoop from behind. Almost gets him. Was super close. No, man, he's still going in. Buddy Blaster is out looking for Stoop and Buds, saving him from the desuited terror. And actually, this is big for Fnatic. They're now bringing this fight right back. Taimu looking for some late heroics, but he is severely outnumbered.
It would be hard to imagine Fnatic losing this at that point, especially with that hook. Maybe with that Roadhog ult, they could have saved it, but he goes right into the pit of doom right there, cleaned up really nice, and they're going to flop the defense over here. Unfortunately, that was 99% to zero. I mean, that's a great way to start any match.
It is, although one thing of note for Fnatic, they have a lot in reserve right now. They still have five ultimates up, so if they ration this out, they really could bring this back. Envy somewhat drained. They'll be getting a few online soon, but this is not the worst case scenario for Fnatic. The worst case would be if they were the ult situation were reversed. Still, they have a long way to go.
Envy also has an extremely long time to drain those ultimates, so I think they're going to try and even things out. They're not really going to want to use anything right now. And what is with this ult today? Everybody wants him.
What an earth shatter. Also, charge into the pit. A little bit of craziness on both sides there. And as a result, Fnatic is still on the winning end. Mickey, though, still alive for Zen. What a hook from Taimu! Throws him into the pit! Taimu pulling this back for Envy. And now Fnatic, will he be able to cause overtime? Coolmat versus the world. This is never a situation you want to be in. Sacrifices his body, throws down a Graviton. Flailing against Destiny as Envy. Looking like they're going to take this round, and they do.
They weren't supposed to win that fight, though. What went wrong? So many people just, I don't know.
It was two things. Mickey was in the back being a terror. I mean, you can never ignore him. He gets maximum value out of the D.Va, and then Taimu just casually walks up and throws someone into the pit.
Pulls him, but...
I mean, it's kind of a three, depending on the angle. We don't know the full angle. Maybe just grabbing this and, you know, hurling it.
Yeah, it's a 1-2 action. Now we're going to be moving on to the Ruins of Ilios. Always an interesting map. Very bizarre for the way King of the Hills usually go. A lot of different strategies in the past. We saw a lot of Widowmakers. Doubt we'll see that today at all, though. Just reminiscing on patches.
There was a map where people thought verticality would really be key. There's definitely in the Pharah meta, we'd always see Pharah here. See her every now and then nowadays, but it's more rare than not. And Fnatic doesn't really look like they're entertaining change-ups here. They're just going forward with full power. Envy also sticking with much of the same as both teams looking to win this additional fight.
Yeah, both very comfortable with what they've been doing. Blood, of course, getting the first hook. Not really able to find that D.Va. Almost with the anti-heal there. Would have been really nice.
But Mickey, though, can get low to start this fight. Does not lose his mech, but creates the opportunity for Fnatic now to start coming in, to start pushing on to Envy. They're winning the poke war ever so slightly right now, but Envy is still keeping honestly healthy in the end. The hook comes up for Taimu, and oh, down he goes! Vonable says, let me help you over the edge, and that's going to be the boop that Fnatic needed to get this ball rolling.
Man, if people just had those boots they wear in Portal, and they just land and come back up, it'd be no problem.
That would be great. That would be great. Although I think we was just hit the water there is the only thing. But either way, Fnatic cleaning up the rest of this fight. Retaking it, but Envy at 38%, and also decent amount of ultimates coming up for the next fight.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be a nice engage here. See if they try and hold close near this choke point, whether or not they hide back. Bloods is a little bit far back, but he's obviously looking for those hooks. I'd like to see them a little bit more forward, a little bit more pressure rather than just letting them get out of there, though. They send in Stoop right away, extra damage, getting the heal on him.
Here comes Harry Hook off the flank, tactical visor with Nana Boost on the way. Bud says, look at me instead, gets moved back. The control on Harry Hook right now, actually insane. Good job by Bud to keep him out of it and keep Fnatic alive versus that flank.
Yeah, who can complain? They held it well, but they came right back with the Lucio boost already in once again. I don't know if they had all of their numbers with them, but they're here to fight. Coolmat has the ultimate, going to stop them right there.
And Fnatic super, super low right now. Look at their health bars on top of the screen. It's a miracle. Most of them are still alive. Only Stoop is dead. They're healing back up. They're still in this fight. Harry Hook looking for the flank around the side, running in the half of Cool instead. And this is a miracle that Fnatic is still in this. And in fact, they might be pulling this back. Buds on the prowl, looking for a hook. Hook comes in, connects, down goes Taimu, and Fnatic going to hold on once more.
I see what you did there. They might pull him, and then the game just sometimes it doesn't happen. Don't really know what's going on there. Bud's just trying to block some small girls with his big belly. It's too brutal. Too brutal for TV.
Poor Mickey getting stalled out there. But that buys Fnatic a lot of time here. Fnatic now on the threshold of only needing one more fight to finish this out. And they have the sound barrier. So Envy is going to be coming into a very tough situation. They have to hope that Taimu gets an early pickoff or Harry Hook really gets the flank of dreams here. Otherwise, Fnatic in a much stronger position.
Yeah, he can definitely start this hook off with a little bit of a good pick. Unfortunately misses it. Looking for who is boosted on the point right now. We have Reaper trying to do some damage, but they've just walked back so efficiently.
They walked right back, and it's kind of sad thinking back to the days where they had speed boost. Reaper, not that nimble, but still 5v5 right now. Better than what Envy could have expected. The Soundbearer has gone down, and Envy has a real legit chance of winning this fight. Cool Matt takes on Harry Hook, 4v4. Here comes Mickey in over the top. What will this get? It gets nothing. The fireworks show not effective, but you know what is? Taimu picking up two, and Envy will be turning this fight in their favor.
Yeah, they're going to need to be able to get the point right here. Again, 99% for Fnatic. This is a strong position for Envious if they can defend this properly. Again, would like to see them hold a little bit more towards the gate. You see they're not pushing forward quite yet. I don't know if they're waiting for players or they're just skittish would be the word I'd go with. But that gate, definitely a great place to start any fight.
Absolutely, and now here's the thing for Fnatic. They really have to question if they want to throw their resources into this. I think they will. I think Happy Cool will open with the self-destruct, but they're going up against a bit of a disadvantage here, and they're also taking their time. So I think no matter what, Fnatic needs to get in here right now, start off this fight, at least give them a chance, a shot of two fights here, and they are finally starting to head in, and Happy Cool holding on to it right now, but Cool Man with the Graviton Surge could turn this the other way, but there's Envy. They're not going to let them get the chance.
Looking for Stoop right now. He threw an Earth Shatter somewhere. Not sure where it went. That was something really big that I think they needed for this fight. Happy Cool still holding on to that ultimate, the D.Va ultimate, and they were Graviton, and more people are going off the side. I'm really not sure what they were expecting out of the engage. They didn't use any of their ults properly.
And the problem there is for Fnatic is that if they had just rolled in when it was about 59%, they would have drawn ults out of Envy and then had ults up for the next thing. Instead, they went for the ult showdown, and now it's going to be a struggle for them to even hit the point in time. They probably will, though who knows? Maybe not. They're not there yet. And yes, Buds connects onto the point at the last moment, but this is looking for a miracle right now for Fnatic. It is 5v5. It's better than expected, but it's still getting very rough as Buds just starting around trying to put Fnatic on the right foot.
Overtime was going down there. I was almost worried for a second no one would get on it. They're trying to keep them off of the point right now. That's all that matters. And ZP, take us through this.
Right now, take a look at Harry Hook just cleaning up the scraps. Fnatic desperately trying to get back onto the point, but that is going to be it. Envious taking it in overtime. Very close between both teams here on Ilios.
Yeah, sorry, I was expecting a little bit more of a fight there. You took us through it, and it was very short. I wanted more of a swan boat ride kind of thing with you, but
unfortunately, you take a look at that, just Fnatic didn't have enough people able to get back in. And this is interesting. So this is a best 3 out of 5 tiebreaker from the looks of it. So taking a look here, Fnatic does have a chance to bring this back, but they're going to have to do the reverse sweep. Easier said than done against a team like Envy, but these have still been very close games here, Stur. So if any team could do it, it would be Fnatic.
Very close, but Envy is still in the lead. And actually, if they win right here, they're going to knock Fnatic down into the loser bracket. So this is their last chance. We're going to have a big standoff here in the beginning. This is one of the most standoffish points on any King of the Hill map ever. There's so much about hooks, but it's such a narrow place to try and get hooks through. It's more about the shield war than ever before.
Alrighty, so Harry Hook right now coming in as the Reaper right now. Chipsogen taking out Custer early on, and winning that Anaviana fight is actually huge here for Envy. Now they're going to have way more healing supporting them, and they can be a little bit more aggro, pushing the Fnatic, and that's exactly what they're doing is Harry Hook going to town with these Hellfire shotguns.
Yeah, definitely interesting. Oh my god, once again to see Reaper shining in a meta where he struggles so much. You have so many things going against Reaper, which is why I haven't seen him lately, but the number one thing is 76 keeps him at bay, but he's nowhere to be seen in this matchup right now.
Not in the least, but hang on, we do have something coming out here. Buds on the McCree. Switch-ups are going to be out here, and he's doing this, I think, to deal with Harry Hook's Reaper, where McCree can really give Reaper a bit of fits. Here comes Harry Hook in over the top of Nano Boost, immediately finds Buds. Buds had no idea it was coming as Harry Hook gets to work in the back. Death Blossom is out, makes it a triple kill before it's all said and done.
Jesus, do I love seeing a character that everyone thinks, you know, we don't see this too often, just comes in before Buds switched to McCree to counter him. Before he even knew where he was dead. Perfect two shots in his head, dropping from above like the Batman.
Like the Batman. Well, he does have the dark and brooding thing going on, so I will give him that. A little bit evil, though. But as we look here, Fnatic coming back in. They do have Soundbearer up. They have the Earth Shatter. Stur, is this one of the biggest windows here for Fnatic as they come in?
It's one of the biggest windows for Harry Hook again. No one seeming to notice him. Don't tell him. And they single out him once again. He gets the Lucio boost, but it's not enough. So much damage coming from that Reaper. Maybe he can get to the health kit. This is the 1v1 of the ages. Even though D.Va helped him, he goes down eventually, and Harry Hook is cleaning up here.
Harry Hook has not had an effective answer. Really, it's just that Fnatic has not been seeing him in time in most of these engagements. However, while Harry Hook was doing work in the back, Fnatic was going to his back line, did a little bit more work, and did manage to retake the point. But still, Envy in a great, great position here.
Yeah, I think the biggest game changer there was the Lucio ult, that it took so long to kill that McCree that, I mean, if you're not making a big difference in the real fight, Harry Hook's been doing great, but if you're focusing that long on one McCree in the back, Fnatic was just taking care of the point, didn't have the Reaper to help them, and here comes one more fight again. We have the ultimate ready.
And here comes Cool Matt. He's gonna drop the Graviton immediately, looking this up the rest of Fnatic. Only picks up two in there. It's not the best Graviton that we've seen from him all day long. Meanwhile, Taimu took out Custa, so again, the healing output for Fnatic absolutely in the can right now. Two kills by Taimu as Envy just slowly rolls forward and mechanically picks everyone off.
Yep, there's one more kill. Looks like we're even going to have another Death Blossom coming out. It's been so long since I've said the word Death Blossom. It just feels good. And we'll see if he hides up in the same spot. They haven't quite noticed him up there a single time yet. Maybe by now they've figured it out if their team communication really worked after Buds got taken down last time. They do have Tracer now. It's not exactly a McCree coming up there, but this fight is definitely going to be all about the Reaper Blossom.
Harry Hook is measuring the offense of Fnatic right now. There's the Nano Boost. He's going to drop down, looking the spin, looking to get that back. Here we go. Death Blossom on the way, spinning, picks up one, makes it two. Harry Hook, man, and who thought Nano Boost Death Blossom was gone, because Harry Hook is bringing it back in style.
And who thought it would be Harry Hook? Always when you talk about Envious, you bring up Taimu is the hard carry. He does so much DPS, he brings so much to the table. But Harry Hook has never really been that person for Envious. And there they are. They take it handily.
Envious coming in very strong there on Ilios, taking the first map of the series. First map was a draw. Second map goes the way
first
of Envy.
First map was not a draw.
First map was a draw.
Was it? Am I that dumb? I've often wondered to myself alone in my closet.
To our tiebreaker map, so Fnatic fighting to stay in that upper bracket. And Stir, can we expect an iron defense from Fnatic here again on the body?
I mean, you could always expect it. I mean, it is a reasonable assumption. I just don't think Envious is going to let it happen again. I feel like it's all been thrown at them already, and they're going to try something that can sort of break them in a new way, because Fnatic is a predictable team. They play a lot of the same team compositions. They play maps very expected, but they just play it well. I think Envy has to come in here with something that can really just get an edge on them.
Well, the key for Envy here is that if they are able to get first pick off as Taimu is rolling forward here on the Roadhog, it's really going to help against this Fnatic defense. Fnatic defense is really just one pitch, one incredibly strong, fast pitch that they've practiced a lot, but they're not throwing a whole lot of variation here. But first fight is underway, and Fnatic really fighting to control this high ground, and they go into the room and really take the fight to Envious here. Coco is down, Happy Cool Gang deep in, and Envy actually wants no further part of that, is already down too.
I was wondering that whole time. Harry Hook got pulled. Did he not die? Apparently he was just having a snooze the whole time up there on Numbani, making sure they kill him at the last possible moment so that he can't regroup with anybody. Really well done. Even when they're winning the fight, they're making sure they win it even more than a lot of teams would, of course, with that sleep dart.
All right, so Envious, a lot of pressure here on their second attack, because if they fail this attack, they are going to be behind in ultimates. Taimu holding back, and Envy's trying to be sneaky here, going around the backside, trying to take the high ground from a different angle, and oh, what a hook on the Cool Matt. Down he goes. Cannot ask for a better hook, and here comes Envy. They're reversing course, getting right back in the Fnatic space, trying to make most advantage of the 6v5, and for now, it's definitely working out. Stoop tries to dive in to even it out. Does not happen.
Yes, he dropped an ultimate there at the last second. It was a little bit of a payload where he got pulled in and immediately stunned a whole bunch of people. Didn't really do too much. We're seeing another one come down from Coco, drop a couple of people in the last couple of moments there.
All right, so Envy going to work here on the second. That's a goodbye Bonnethil. Vicky with the shove. A little bit of revenge for all the environmental kills he got back on Ilios. As Envy, they don't have this point yet, but Fnatic is in a very rough position. Very unlikely they'd be able to retake it at this point.
Mickey just mercilessly getting inside Reinhardt's face. There was, for some reason, nothing he could do about it, I suppose, trying to walk forward to the point. But dying here is always a massive inconvenience, considering how far back you spawn, and Harry Hook is already up here, getting even more of those hooks with his hook brother, Taimu, over there.
Taimu applying the pressure here, and this is where Fnatic has to be careful. Teams oftentimes give up way too much in Streets phase because of momentum. They just need to take a breath and come back in.
Yeah, they definitely have a great setup here for a watching everyone come in, taking some damage, not letting them get set up. Harry Hook already on the high ground with the ultimate. I think that's what we're going to have to look for here. The cart moving ever so slowly, though. As much as they want to move forward, Stoop is trying to stop them.
All right, well, here comes Harry Hook. Flanking to the back line. Here he goes. TacVisor on the way. Doesn't have as many targets as he was expecting, but does find Custa. Gets on the half a cool. It's a double kill here from Harry Hook, and I believe he's done his job as Russa Envy is swarming in right behind him.
Ooh, charging, getting stuck on stairs. The one thing Reinhardt can't climb, stairs. They are too powerful, and the cart is still moving. No matter how this fight is going, is it still inching forward? No, I believe someone walked away from it. You gotta push that thing.
Well, the cart right now in progress by just one player on Team Envy, but Envy perhaps not getting as much from that as they were hoping for. Fnatic will have a chance to reestablish here, and Halas going to be on the Graviton of Cool Man. He's going to be able to come in and try and stop Envy right here before second. It is 5v5. Taimu is already down, though, and there's the Graviton from Cool Man, sucking them up, setting them up as Half a Cool will get the cleanup in the very end. Fnatic will hold on to point two just a little bit longer.
Yeah, no additional ults needed there, and maybe now when they push forward with Harry Hook, they'll actually have the cart far enough forward to help with how far back he actually is behind the enemy lines. That will be a start. We only have Chips right now with the ultimate. Coco just getting it online. Not sure if that's going to be enough to push with. Fnatic doesn't have that many either. It depends who's going to get the really big Earth Shatter here, I think.
All right, well, Fnatic, they're looking to take the initiative. They open up with the D.Va self-destruct. Don't get too much from it. Time move counters, takes down Custa. Fnatic could be down all sorts of healing now as a result. Stoop drops the Earth Shatter, gets absolutely nothing. Panic ult at Fnatic. Pure panic coming out. And as a result, Envy is cleaning up almost a fully clean fight from the side of Envy, and as a result, they're going to keep the payload pushing forward and carry momentum into third.
Stoop, if I'm your dad, I'm disappointed. Like, I mean, you Earth Shattered, and I appreciate it. You're putting in work. That wall's never going to be the same, but it was questionable, to say the least.
It was panic. There's no other way of describing it where things were going down. He thought, all right, I'm going to use an Earth Shatter. Did not get what he was looking for. Envy, meanwhile, being aggressive. Mickey with the double kill self-destruct in the back line as Envy keeps the pain train rolling forward. Fnatic falling apart before our eyes.
Yep, just cleaning up these last couple of shots here. Chips doesn't really even matter. He already has ultimate, but putting that extra damage into everyone. Going to line up for one more defense here, coming out of the spawn.
And for Envy, they could not ask for a better position. And here comes Harry Hook. He's going up on the side flank here, looking for the Nanovisor. Chips, gonna be his buddy, tags him in. Here comes Nanovisor in over the top, immediately dispatches Custa. A bad day to be an Ana if you're playing for Fnatic right now. Harry Hook picks up two, and here comes Envy once more. The stage has been set.
This has just been constantly moving forward ever since they were stuck up on second point. Harry Hook is not even being contested. He has Lucio ult, but no one's shooting him. No one was shooting him in the first place. He didn't need the extra health. Cool Matt getting evaporated by these shots. Ana saving him in the last couple of moments, and that big explosion, not doing anything.
Fnatic trying to fight this back. They do have the respawn advantage here. Coco and Internet Hook will fall, so Envy perhaps not fighting that as cleanly as they would have liked. They let Fnatic a little bit back in, and as a result, Fnatic will be able to reestablish for at least one more defensive hold. But the upside here for Fnatic, Stir, what do you think of Cool Matt having a Graviton here? Doesn't have much follow-through, but what can we expect?
I mean, it really depends if Mickey up there is going to be able to stop him. You have to keep track of these Zarya ults more than any other. And if you can really get in his face, we saw it earlier, obviously, Shadowburn has been so good at denying Gravitons across multiple characters, really. But that's what we're going to need to see. Don't see it. He gets an ultimate, but not enough people in it.
Yeah, Stoop was looking for the fall through there, looking to just Anno hammer his way to victory. It does get Coco killed, but not much else. But you know what? That might be okay for Fnatic here. It still causes Envy the backup. They don't like the fight they're taking, but they are able to save a lot in terms of ultimates and will have them up for the next fight.
Yeah, it really didn't kill anyone. Nothing really happened, but it was enough to stall them just long enough that they're going to have to come back. They're going to have to push again. We're going to see if Stoop doesn't ult a wall this time. I think that's the next crucial thing on the line. But Envious has a lot of ults here. We're probably going to see a Harry Hook boost in just a moment. See if they can get him around the back again would be quite interesting. Always like seeing that on this last point here.
All right, well, Stoop right now is looking for that Earth Shatter, is looking for that instant redemption. Here comes Chips, though. Gonna throw the nano boost out. Harry Hook in the back line, attack visor, not getting as much as he wants. Immediately has to back off. Meanwhile, Fnatic, they're still together. This can give Stoop an opportunity to come in and look for that redemption shatter. Here comes Mickey, self-destruct though, into the back line. Does not get what he's looking for. It is a brawl in all senses of the word right here. Cool Matt is down, but Taimu gets up, so Fnatic still very much in this fight.
Yeah, they really didn't get a lot out of that initial fight, and it looks like they're going to be able to bring this back. Stoop comes in, drops a whole bunch of them on the ground. This is going to be a quick cleanup for them, and they all explode. Half a cool with the ultimate to follow it up, looking great. And I got to say, That was a perfect defense from them. The way they rotated back, they weren't affected by the 76. It didn't surprise them. They were all together. They were all able to support each other, and they move as a blob.
Look at how much Mickey is getting stalled here. That was phenomenal. Just the top off was a great defense there from Fnatic, where they waited a really long time, but Stoop's patience paid off. You know what? He's redeemed himself for shattering that wall, because half a cool had the fall through, took out everyone, and now Envy, only 22 seconds left here. They don't have much time.
They're going back on what worked last time. We have Harry Hook coming around the back as Reaper. See if he's going to be able to find a couple shots in the back, waiting patiently for a speed boost, I believe. Able to get in the back, but the sleep finds him. He's on the ground.
He's on the ground. Earthshatter coming in from Envy, trying to pull this back in their favor. They do take down Custa. First kill is theirs. Second kill is theirs. Fireworks on the cool mat. 4v6. Fnatic trying to stall this out. They are losing players rapidly. The Sound Bear comes out late in the fight. Too late to really turn it. This is full and clean right now from Envy. They're going to push this card forward, and it's looking like they will cap out Nambani with no time remaining, but a spirited defense from Fnatic at the end.
It's really weird that they go to a Reaper at the end, and that's the good thing that Envy has right now. In a meta where no one's playing a Reaper, but I mean, right now, Fnatic isn't playing any ranged DPS. I mean, at most, you're going to have to watch out for that sleep, but you eventually wake up, and he still followed up with the kills after it anyway.
The Reaper has been surprisingly effective, and Reaper, of course, does have some issues dealing with D.Va, but I think part of it is that Hapakul has been playing so overly aggressive on his D.Va that he's not really where Harry Hook is when the Reaper is in play. Of course, there is the instant replay of that phenomenal D.Va explosion set up by Stoop, who really held his time, held on to the Earth Shatter for quite a while, but then found it right at the perfect moment.
So what kind of defense do you think we're going to be able to see here from Fnatic? The one, the only.
Defense coming out here from the side of Envy. Well, you're taking a look at it. Internet Hulk is going to be coming out here on the Symmetra. Mickey coming out on the Torbjorn. So fans of Symmetra Torb.
No, he's messing with us again. Messing with us. The second I saw the Torb, come on, man.
We've seen Symmetra Torb. Now, it might be a thing, but no. Sad times. All right, well. I wanted to believe, given recent history, but sometimes recent history, not enough.
I don't like Mickey anymore, but I do like Internet Hulk. It's surprising to see after he used to be so well known for his Winston, he's been playing a lot of support lately. He's been on Lucio. He's got some Metro duty right now, which is always really cool to see. I'm glad she got a rework where she's finally seeing some play again. And this is a fantastic map for some Metro play. There's so many places to hide. Multiple buildables now.
It is a good map for Symmetra play, but I will note that this is still a gamble coming out here from Envy, because Nambani is probably the most momentum-based payload map in the entire game. If you give up a super, super clean first point, it can really stick with you all the way through second and even into last. So for Envy, winning this first fight feels very important.
Hook misses. They already used the speed boost. They're not going to be able to come out of here with that much haste, but they're already going forward, taking a bottom route. Both hooks missing. Not too many hooks for anybody.
Well, Bud's able to grab Harry Hook early on, so Fnatic with the first strike, diving into Envy here in the lower ground, but Coco swings the hammer, ends up picking up two. Envy is fighting this right back, and that is all sorts of as Internet Hulk going crazy towards the end, picks up the double kill, and it's shield generator time. Or teleporter, but probably shield generator.
And there it is in the back. You got a shield generator at the bottom of the stairs. Let's see if it's as stealthy as it was before in previous matches where nobody could exactly find where it was. And the gigantic radius on that makes it really difficult to pinpoint where it is. You gain benefit from a far range. And even if you walk out of the range, you keep it for a little while. So it keeps people guessing.
Absolutely. And this is rough times here for Fnatic. It's going to make every subsequent attack harder. They have no real idea where it is. I think part of why Buds is on Tracer now. Oh, is he finding it? He was looking for it, but Taimu stops him. So now, does Fnatic go in 5v6 and feed ultimates? Like, I mean, they could try. It wouldn't be that great of an idea. They're flirting with it, but they end up losing Vaunthil. Now they really have to back out.
Yeah, that went bad for them before they even walked out of top. And then once they're at top, it's like, do we commit? This is so bad. I mean, even if they fought, maybe they could have tried to build ultimates, but then so is Envy. And they're going to wait and try this again. I suppose Buds could try and get in the back. And they're not even going to get a chance. That was an amazing pick there by Harry Hook.
Harry Hook taking out Custa really early on in that fight. And again, this is going to stall Fnatic even more. The last two pushes for Fnatic have not even been pushes. It's been going up, losing someone early on, not able to do something. Look at this. Buds on a mission. He's looking for shield generators, and I think he's about to find this one. There it is. He's found his prize. Taimu, though, staying in on him. This is not necessarily an easy shield generator pick. It's going to start regenerating soon, so you must defeat my Taimu to stand a chance. But here comes Internet Hulk looking to protect. While that's going on, by the way, Fnatic is coming in on the main point, but just getting murdered by the Nanovisor.
Yeah, Harry Hook is just up here, free reign to do anything. They're pretty much down a player with them looking around in the back, trying to figure out what's going on. He's still up here finding even more shots.
There is one good part, though. Buds was able to take down the shield generator, so the raid boss is done, if nothing else. But so much time has been bled off the clock here. Three ultimates up for Envy in the next fight. It's not even a great fight for Fnatic coming up, but it's probably a fight they need to win, because I'll tell you what, Storth, how quick Internet Hulk was building it up, he's probably going to have the shield generator if they lose this fight.
Well, Fnatic did just get everything online. They have Coolmat with an ultimate. Buds is going to be able to combo. Hafakul has something. It all just came up online all at once. When people get put onto the ground, and everything goes as bad as it could possibly go. Mickey finds the tactical nuke.
They just rolled right into his trap card. Mickey exploding three people before it is all said and done. And now for Fnatic, down to 50 seconds here, Stir. How much of a hero are they going to have to be with these tank ultimates to win this next fight?
They have to do it this time. I mean, their last push was their best shot at it. This one isn't bad either. They still have Coolmat with the Graviton, which enables everything. Hafakul, of course, great D.Va player, is going to be able to find that explosion off of that stoop. Going to be able to ult and wall a wall at some point here, but it'll all be all right. We have the Graviton Surge coming down. Hafakul already with it in there, able to get a couple of kills, not as many.
Well, the opening is pretty decent here from that. They pick up two to start things off. They have Envious in full retreat. They do not have full control of the point here just yet, but they are working on Stoop, swinging the hammer. Coco going to fall, and Fnatic finally might be getting the Doomfist rolling here. Taimu going to waddle right up here, look to get a hook or do something to stall it out, but he is the sacrificial lamb taken out as he tries to bring it back in. Harry Hook gets the nano boost, but it's almost certainly too little, too late, as Fnatic too overpowering on the play. I mean, Envious is still starting to come back here. There is the possibility they've made it closer than you would expect, because Internet Hulk put down the teleporter mid-fight. That's why they're getting those reinforcements.
I didn't even notice. He has obviously the option for the shield generator, but you can't forget about how useful the teleporter can be. Unfortunately, it's not enough, and they did use an incredible amount of ults to try and save that. They used boost, everything.
We didn't really see it from our perspective. I'm sitting here thinking, I was like, wait a second, this fight is pretty much over, and suddenly there's three people coming in. The teleporter absolutely came in mid-fight, so sort of the flexibility of Symmetra when you're running it there. Unfortunately, even with the quick reinforcements, was not quite enough. And take a look at Buds right now. Buds is going to be looking to creep up, maybe get the early pulse bomb pick.
Yeah, but even before, with them wasting ults, we see Envious right now with nothing. Taimu also really helped Coolmat build up to, again, 90% ultimate on Zarya. He pretty much just used that thing with how much healing he was doing to himself, letting Zarya blast him. So I think this fight could be another clean one for Fnatic here in just a moment.
Well, pulse bomb comes off raw from Buds, takes down Coco early on. Doesn't need to be comboed with Coolmat for the big bang, but that's big here for Fnatic. They're going to be able to keep this moving forward. Minimum expenditure of resources, and Coolmat just content to land the damage on the front side. Not using Graviton just yet, but with Custom Gang picked up by Harry Hook, now Fnatic really has to decide how much they want to commit to this fight.
I think I just saw a boosted baby D.Va there who got into a mech, which gets rid of it. I'm not exactly sure what happened there. Pretty unfortunate fight there from Fnatic, but if there is a silver lining to it, Coolmat kept his ultimate. I don't think he was able to find the right targets. A lot of their supports that he probably could have ulted were up on the high ground, and he maybe just didn't see them.
All right, well, the Graviton comes out from Coolmat towards the end. Get pull in two. There's the bang from Hafakul. Two dead from that Graviton. 3-1 in favor of Fnatic here on this fight. Harry Hook can try and be a hero of the Nanovisor, but when Hafakul's in your face with that Korean Future Vacuum, it is not going to happen. Fnatic well on their way to taking the second point.
Future Vacuum, I'm going to start selling those. That's not a bad idea. Again, we have the most important part of the map right here. This is always the hardest one on Numbani. I mean, the first point is really hard, but then once you get to this corner, this bend, it becomes a little bit complicated. There's so many ways to do it. Buds hiding in the back, though, almost with the Pulse Bomb, going to start this off really well for his team.
Absolutely. Note here, too, for Fnatic, they have a real chance of putting themselves in an amazing situation here if they can finish this out with at least a minute and 1 second remaining due to how Time Bank works. So this is really their window of opportunity to win this map out. Right, Buds just hanging out here at the Pulse Bomb, waiting to go in. Dives right in, Pulse Bomb 6 on the Coco, does connect, and here comes Fnatic diving into the backline. Buds looking for a little bit more. Sound Bear is down, Coolmat takes down Coco from that Pulse Bomb damage, and now Envious in full retreat.
Well, not exactly retreat. They're just not sure if they want to fight or not. It seems like they want to retreat, but they're kind of stuck off in this weird situation. They're really spread out right now. It's Fnatic all around the point at the moment. taking that defensive situation. Taimu switches over to the McCree in the last second, finding a couple shots onto D.Va. Not really sure where any enemies are off to his left. It looks like Fnatic is just backed up for the moment, taking their time. Buds peppering some damage in there, trying to build some ult. Harry Hook on the side. Again, they're going with this double hit scan strategy.
And both teams even 66 right now. Deadeye coming out here from Taimu. It is high noon, but there are no skulls to be found. And while that's going on, oh my goodness, he finds Buds at the last moment. Buds not get respect. Evens up 5v5. Here comes Cool Matt. Graviton on the way, pulls in one. Coco just struggling to live. Will get taken down at the end. And Fnatic keeping the mem going here, Stir. They're not going to be able to do it with over a minute left, but they very well could finish out this map.
Yeah, still so much going on the cart. We have, of course, D.Va's fighting, boosted, not going to be able to kill that, just chasing down the supports, pushing them into walls, getting back onto the cart, and it's going to be a slow stagger from Envious, but I think they're going to have enough players here in a second to be able to hold this maybe a little bit longer.
Well, the explosion does come down from Havoc Cool, but it is a brawl in the fight, but that favors Envy as they are cleaning up Fnatic. The respawns are coming in, and Fnatic, now with 20 seconds left, Stir, they're going to have one final push, and they are going to have to do a mad dash just to get that push.
Yeah, whenever you have to push like this, whenever it's like the last 15 seconds, and right now they really need to start going now from how far away they are at this moment. It's going to be messy. It's going to be sloppy. This is going to be incredibly difficult to win, but it's going to be D.Va from the back getting on the cart to contest it.
All right, Fnatic fighting for their lives here, fighting the same. The upper bracket. Here we go. We're in overtime. Can Fnatic bring this back? Havoc Cool going to the back line. Trying to get in Taimu's face, creating a little bit of space. Poke War relatively even between the both teams. Both D.Va's relatively low. Sound Bear in from Fnatic, but it is not enough. Cool Matt goes down. 5v5 here on the point. Harry Hook, though, the attack visor, gets a key pick on the bot, though. And here comes the explosion of Mickey and over the top. And that's going to be enough. Envy will hold in the end. And they will defeat Fnatic, sending them to the lower bracket.
The CPI.